Hi, good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to Safari TV, PM Safari. And my name is Patrick, and I'll be presenting and guiding this afternoon. And Kev is on camera again with me on the Ganda this afternoon, and Jerry in power control. So the three of us, and we'll be taking us around for the next 2.5 hours of the drive and see what we can find for you. And if you've got any questions during the course of the drive, you can send them through to power control at safari.tv, and I'll answer them to the best of my ability. Okay, so without wasting time, so let's go and have a look around. It's such a very beautiful afternoon. And the summer is busy kicking the doors and windows. Nice and warm. In the heart of the African bush. In the Sabi Sands. Quarantine is pretty quiet this afternoon. No impalas, zebras, white dogs, giraffes. And we often see congregating around quarantine by this time of the afternoon. Just chilling under some shades and chewing the cord. Suppose in the most of the animals are down in the riverine areas, feeding and resting some shades over there. And they would obviously emerge from the bushes and move up into the higher ground for some warmth and safety after dark. The drive was delayed this afternoon because Alex was busy fixing something on the vehicle. So the plan for this afternoon, we're going to be scratching around the southern part of our concessions. Three dams, three house dam in the area. The signal on Twin Dam seems to be a lot more better than it was before. So we'll see how it goes this afternoon in terms of signal wise. And again, game activities. I believe you saw in Duna this morning on the Impala Kill, somewhere off Central Road.
through the dip. Some buffalo, hey, what a good start this afternoon. Apparently, a Yambelio don was also seen this morning, but unfortunately, he crashed over into Touchwood. Dagger boys, it's quite a few of them, yeah. This is the female walking across the road in front of us. Oh, sorry. There's quite a few females here. With the Dagger boys. These other Dagger boys are about to cross the road as well. Posing for a picture. It's very photogenic this afternoon. Here comes another young bull. It's a very nice and mild temperature this afternoon. That's why the Dagger boys are up feeding at this time of the day. Every time when I find a group of Dagger boys like this, and I think of Sisa and George. It's They were wonderful characters here in Western Gari. They disappeared for a very long time, and they showed up about a month ago at Bowsing Dam, and then they disappeared again. Very inquisitive animals, the buffalo bulls. Yeah, oops, could you jump? I'll bring in. Good afternoon, Ja. Tara boys, Philemon Step. Okay, copy. Thanks, man. Where is Dangala?
Yeah, Dangala is from this morning. Dangala Papa Mayele.
Okay, copy. Thanks, man. Alrighty. Let's move along. I haven't seen lions in Gari in a while. now where the two lines from the six spot went. We lost to see them at Belsic Dam. Also wondering where the rest of the six spot is. Anyone knows where the six spot is? And in Chingalans, Pochos. Is it as now? Just for the interest sec. No buffers. There's lots of flies this afternoon again. Buzzing around my face and ears.
Hi there, folks. Jared again here in Final Control. And while Patrick makes his way towards Treehouse Dam, of course, we don't get very good signal on the way there, so we'll just stand by for Pat as he gets in. Hopefully, when he becomes stationary, the signal will be back. So let's see how we go.
Okay, welcome back on Uganda, folks, and we are at Treehouse Dam at the moment, and lots of buffaloes lying down on the water's edge, and the bees are chewing their cord. Didn't have a mud bath today. the squirrel alarm calling on the south inside of the dam. Grey Lurie or Galway Bird is also calling. It might be a bird of prey or a snake annoying the squirrels in that area. I've got a long distance visual of a head of impala on the other side of the dam, but they seem to be happy and feeding nicely. So I don't think that there is something major. Impala would have gone crazy if there was a predator in that vicinity. Alrighty. Let's move on again. The buffaloes aren't doing much. Up again on along Lying down or something, see that the big black round thing, yeah. Tree,
yeah?
Yeah. And it looks through really those bushes there.
Well, do you want to go and have a look?
No, no, it's fine, yeah. It's too thick there. So there's my little tree here, and there's another tree at the back.
Yeah.
And it looks slightly to the left through the back up, there's a very big black thing lying down. It looks like a hippo. It's very hard to see. Tambi Darabois, La Fancy, Kihazde. It's a group of Dara boys lying up at tree house there.
Thank you.
What's the replay in this afternoon? Nothing special so far. Just the Dara boys. I love this show this afternoon.
Thank you.
Alrighty. On Shibama Road, heading south at the moment. We're going to take Gowrie Man Road and head east towards Queen Dance. This morning, Doing up, headed into Milwaukee, east of Treehouse Dam. Just want to try our luck. Evidently, the chest of pride that killed the buffalo at Sydney Dam a couple of nights ago crossed into Manulata Reserve. This morning they had the tracks crossing over into Manulata Reserve. Thank you. donkeys in pajamas up ahead. Zebis, Bartels, Zebras. Well, you can call him a plain zebras if you like. Yeah. Moving into the bushes away from us. It's awesome cooties there. Moving into thick bushes to try and stay away from the irritating flies. Well, I can see one there's got Natalia. But we won't be able to pick him up with the camera, because he's behind the trees at the moment. Could have been to the close encounters with the lions and managed to escape, obviously. And sometimes you see the zebras with a very big gash on the body from the lions. When the gash heals up, and then you can see that the stripes joint skewed. Alrighty. Sounds like there's quite a few vehicles out on drive this afternoon. a good thing. To have a lot of vehicles out, there's obviously more ears and eyes out there looking for different things. Lilac breasted roller. Very, very stunning bird. He's foraging for food in his open grasslands. Rollers are widely distributed throughout the Greater Kruger National Park. Just listening. What I'm saying about it. Kimmy, good afternoon to you. And Kimmy's asking about zebras and how fast can a zebras run. Full speed. Probably about 60-65 kilometers per hour. That is incredibly fast for a human. The fastest man that was ever recorded many years ago was as fast as 32-33 kilometers per hour. Quite windy out here. You can see the roller in the tree is shaking. Oh, lovely. Shall we? Yeah, it was also breaking up, but good yourself?
Very, very well.
Good, man.
What did you see?
Just the buffaloes, and not much. Where did you see them? Treehouse Dam, yeah?
Oh, Treehouse
Dam. Yeah, there are quite a few of them here, just lying up by the water here.
Okay.
Cool.
Well, we're going to have a look up there now.
Okay, wonderful.
Thank you.
But other than that, it's still quite so far, yeah.
Put us on TV.
Yeah. Okay, enjoy. Alrighty. Beagle is going the other way. You can also carry on the main road.
Yes.
Okay, the first road on the right hand side. Okay, you take that one and you drive down about 300-400 meters down the road and then you turn left again and it will take you to Treehouse Dam, yeah.
Right, I think I'm gonna go this way and then turn
up that way, yeah. That's also the quickest way, yeah.
Cool.
Okay, thanks guys.
Thank you.
Okay, ciao. Hi folks, welcome back, and Gunda, sorry about the constant summer breakup in this area. We're going to be moving out of this area into the good seasonal area, talking to the landowners there. Okay. You seem to be looking good for now. We are still on Twin Dams, heading north towards Chelapan. For those who are following us on the map. But Chelapan is actually not in the Juma map. Tracks here, probably from Nduna this morning. Hi Neil, good afternoon to you. Neil is asking if I can imitate the Lalak crested roller call. Quite a difficult one. Hello, Impala. The log crested riders make a very funny. Rhino on the Firebrack north of Belsic Dam. Really sound like I can't really do it. I'm sorry. I'll try another day. And Kim was also asking if we could go to the Hyena Band this afternoon. Certainly I would like to go to the Hyena Band. I haven't been to the band since it was located a couple of days ago. McDonald's of the Bush in Palace. So everyone pretty much eating the McDonald's. These are very, very common antelope species throughout the Sabi Sand in the Great Exclamation Park.
Okay. Ah, good afternoon, Team Alin. Alin is asking about the hyenas. Hyena question. Asking if who is the mother of the new babies at the dam? Flappy ear, the baby sitter of last year. Apparently, Flappy ear is the mother of the babies, and now last year, and she was babysitting the babies for another hyena. The part of the clan. So I think the one that we saw sitting by the dam is babysitting the Flappy Ears babies this time. I'm not too sure, but who was she? Because I was not on draft that day, but I saw you on the picture, but didn't have a good look at here. Yeah.
Good afternoon to you, Wambuff. I presume this is Chetnam. Asking if we do get any ostriches in our area. Just to begin with Wombeth, Tara told me this afternoon, just before we went live, that there was a report of ostriches on the radio somewhere in Chitakatlan this morning. Obviously, she didn't get to see them because we found them just towards the end of the drive this morning. But I have never seen the ostrich since I've been here. So I've been here for about a year now. This is not an ideal habitat for the ostriches. It's too thick for them. That's why we don't get to see them in this part of the Sabis Sand. Obviously, in this time of the year, then they can't come through because the bush is less thicker and also the tall grass is also dying and getting shorter. The ostriches prefer in the large open grasslands, which we don't have yet. All the rhino tracks over here. Negative, nothing from my side so far. No tracks either, Ahem. Yeah, affirmative. I'm actually making my way towards the pier now. Turning on to Gauri Katlan. We'll have a signal breakup. Towards Bersa Katlan. And once we go through the dip, and then it will be fine. All the way to Bersa Dam. Thank you. Mulula was seen briefly at Bafsuk Dam a couple of days ago. She must have crossed over into Bafsuk. Be nice to see the 3 liters of gorilla. Possibly around December, January there, but because the cubs will be kept undercover for at least 2 to 3 months before she can introduce them to the vehicles. Very interesting. My name is Andrew in Maryland. Madeline. Hi, Andrew in Maryland.
Hi there, folks. Jared again. And while Patrick just makes his way through onto Biffles Hill cut line, we do break up in this area generally. And as soon as Patrick gets to the other side of the hill, we'll be back with Patrick. And just a quick shout out from Final Control to Betts's grandkids, Andrew and Madeline. Hi there, guys. And I'm sure Patrick will give you a shout out again when the reception is a bit better.
Okay, welcome back on Uganda. Again, we are on the cut line heading east at the moment. A very warm welcome to Andrew in Madeline. I hope you are enjoying the drive with us this afternoon. If you've got any questions, you can send them through to Final Control Safari.tv and in Medellin. I will answer it live on air. driving along the fire break. I don't know, right inside here. It's been burned about 3-4 months ago. I can't wait to see during the raining season. There'll be lots and lots of different antelope species feeding on along the band area here in the next 3-4 months or so. Is the Shimla and Columbia coming? Yeah. I'm on perhaps a cut line north of Kelsey Bay. Okay, copy. Thanks, man. How many vehicles are there now? Cool, I'll be joining you shortly. Right now, I'm drinking water on the northern side of the dam, Andrew Sais. And if I bypass you, Andrew? No. Pull up here. Let's go for the show. Hi, good afternoon. Cool, thank you. How's it going, though? Been on a holiday. Try the other side of the dam. Awesome.
No.
It's for Ryanair's Day. This is called a crash of Ryanair. Crash. It's a collective terminology for a group of Ryanairs together. That one is having a mud bath at the back there, yeah? The great deal of feeding takes place mainly in the late afternoon and again in the early mornings. And obviously during the day I just find some shades and take it easy for the day. They also take a nap during the night, so they will feed for a period of time and they'll start feeding and then just lie down for a couple of hours or so, and then continue feeding until the early mornings. This buoy closer to us looks like it wants to lie down as well. Two days ago, Kathy and I found a big bull rhino bull with the young cow and followed him for a while and eventually got to Chidakatan and lie down there. And the female was lying flat on one side, which is something that I've never seen a rhino lying down or sleeping like in that position before. It was very weird for me. The bull is marking his territory. He's dragging his hind legs and then spraying at the same time. I didn't know that it is Simpiwa's birthday today. And I believe everyone is saying happy birthday to Simpiwa. So happy birthday, Simpiwa. I hope you are enjoying your birthday, wherever you are this afternoon. I think Simpiwa is back tomorrow. So this time of the year we see rhinos regularly here in Western Gari, whereas in this Oh, wow. That was really nice. We don't see lots of rhinos during summer times. Maybe one rhino every 1 week or 2 weeks or so. Let's look at the female rhino horn. It's very, very impressive, very nice and long and sharp. This bull is standing by himself here close to us, and I've never seen him before. This time I see him in a concession. The other bull rhinos also set marking. It doesn't look like short horn. The short horn is a dominant bull rhino in this area. I think the other rhino bull that was standing closer to us might be new in this area. interestingly, the dominant bull rhino will allow the other rhino bull to access his territory for water and food in the dry season, and as long as they behave themselves and respect him. They're gone. Why do we do then? We should also continue before we carry on, and Kev just gonna quickly show you the hippos still chilling out nicely in the water. They'll be heading out to eat after dark. They are slipping. Alrighty, that was nice, eh? Nice and combi. So for those who have just tuned in, we are coming to you live from Juma Game Reserve. Sabi Sands. My name is Patrick, presenting and guiding this afternoon. Kev on camera and Jared in final control. If you would like to ask any questions relating wildlife, feel free to send it to followcontrol@safari.tv. What they did here, there's a pile of wood here on the shit erosion system here. It's actually a gully erosion system, not the shit erosion. So this is the erosion control. It's every year in the rain takes away a certain amount of soil and creates erosion. So they're trying to stop it here by piling up the wood here. Sometimes they do what we call brush packing, or they'll chop off the pieces of branches and deposit them on the area where the erosion is taking place, just to try and stop it. This is a very old fashion of a soil erosion prevention. Most of the lodges, what they do to prevent soil erosion, they pack up some rocks,
or omeg gabions. So gabions is basically you collect rocks and you pack them nicely in order in a chicken wire, and they also put what they call it. It is sort of a blanket. You would put it around it when the rain comes and pushes the soil, and then it is stopped against the gabion, so it doesn't wash it away. They call it gabions. We don't have any of them in this area, but I was gonna show you how it looks like. Just having a better idea what I am talking about. But that also looks fine. To do the brush packing, or just pack up some wood or rocks or anything like that, or even grass. You can plant grass. That will also stop erosion. Yeah, we are on Vibber Road. We're gonna go and check to the cut line to the south. Maybe lucky with Yambili or Dani, you never know. Laurie, good afternoon to you. Laurie's asking about the temperature out here at the moment. I'm not too sure. What would you say, Kev? Temperature? 22. Kev says maybe you can check for us outside the final control, Gerald. Okay. And, Jared also reckons about 20 degrees at the moment. So it's around there, around 22 degrees, thereabouts. Looks like we're going to have a stunning sunset this afternoon. lorry again, asking how cold does it get overnight. Very cold, extremely cold. I would say probably about 10 degrees. It's also very cold in the early mornings before the sun rises. Sometimes I battle but up in this area, in the northern part of the Sabi Sand, doesn't get as cold as the southern part of the Sabi Sand. And the reason why it gets too cold down there is because of a large perennial river system that runs through the southern part of the Sabi Sand into the Kruger National Park. And over here, obviously, you don't get. Don't have the permanent river system that runs through. That is one of the disadvantages of the northern part of the Sabi Sand. Gerard Keff and I worked at Singita Liboma in the Kruger. Wow, that area is freezing cold in winter. So when you go out and drive in the early mornings, you need to put at least 4 or 5 layers on you, otherwise you're gonna freeze. It's very cold. You have Mwanetsi River that runs past the lodge on the eastern side, and also the Lubumba Mountains in front of the lodge. And you've got a Sweni River that comes from the southwest and joins with the Lubumba. Wow. You don't know, want to know how cold it gets in winter in that area. Hyena tracks. I'm just gonna do Mamba Road, Mamba and Drunkensberg Drive through to Spaghetti Crossing. Gonna try and get to the Hyena Den before we lose the light. Let's see if we can make it this afternoon. Hyena Den, Pisikaya. Wee Kaya. Just wondering where the hyenas are going to go when they leave the den. Because they've got a few den sites within our concession. See as the time goes by. I'm not going to make any predictions at the moment. It's still way too early. I think the quickest route to get to the den is Central Road. So we're not gonna do Batelier Road through Spaghetti Crossing, so we're gonna do Central Road instead.